Welcome back, students. We have completed unit 2 successfully. Okay, let's go to the unit 3. Okay. Unit 3 consists of two parts. Okay, one is frequency management and channel assignment. Second one is cell coverage for signal and traffic. Okay, unit 3 is somewhat bigger with respect to unit 2. Okay, it consists of two parts. One is frequency management and channel assignment. Second one, cell coverage for signal and traffic. Okay, let's go to the contents. What are the contents consists here? So, in the first part, frequency management and channel assignment, the topics are numbering and grouping, setup, access and paging channels. Channel assignment to cell sites and mobile units, fixed channel and non-fixed channel assignment, channel sharing and borrowing, last one, overlay access. See, these are the topics in the first part of unit 3, that is frequency management and channel assignment. Coming to second part, that is cell coverage for signal and traffic. Okay, the contents are with respect to signal reflections in flat and hilly terrain, so effect of human-made structures, phase difference between direct and indirect paths, okay, reflected paths, straight line path loss slope, general formula for mobile, propagation over water and flat open area, near and long distance propagation, antenna height gain, form of a point to point model. So it is somewhat more with respect to first part. Okay. So these are the two topics, okay, or the two parts which we used to cover in unit 3. Okay, so unit 3 has two parts. One is frequency management channel assignment, second one, cell coverage for signal and traffic. Okay, in today's class we will learn about what is mean by frequency management. Okay, frequency management. Okay, what do you mean by numbering of channels? What do you mean by numbering? And what is meant by grouping? Okay, what is meant by numbering of channels? What is meant by grouping of channels? Okay, only for first topic. We will learn about only first topic in the first part of unit 3. Okay, so let's go to the topic numbering and grouping, and we will learn some points about what is meant by frequency management and a few points about what is meant by channel assignment. Okay, we will learn about frequency management, channel assignment, what do you mean by numbering, what mean by grouping of the channels, right? So, what is meant by frequency management? Okay, management, you know what is meant by management, we are managing something. Here, it is with respect to channels. Okay, how we will manage the channels? So, frequency management is to divide the total number of available channels into subsets. Okay. So, we should divide the available channels into some subsets. Anyway, there will be a frequency chart. Okay, I will clearly show what is meant by subset, which can be assigned to each cell either in a fixed fashion or dynamically. So, there exists a cell site. We have to assign these subsets or these channels to the respective cell set. Okay, how many subsets are we going to assign with respect to cell set? Okay, it depends upon the density, okay, number of years existing cell set. Anyway, it's a different topic. Now, coming to only frequency management, we are dividing the number of available channels into subsets, and we are assigning the subsets to the cell site, okay, in a fixed fashion. Fixed fashion means only some 100 number of channels exist in this cell set. That's it. Okay. Or dynamically. Dynamically means we can borrow. Okay. That's the difference concept. That is channel borrowing. Okay. So dynamically we can assign, fixedly we can assign with respect to channels in the cell set, with respect to cell set or with respect to mobile. Next, it refers to designating setup channels. Huh? There exists a setup channels. I will clearly tell you what is meant by setup channel. We have a frequency chart in the coming slides. Okay, in the slide, I can clearly show you what are the setup channels there, what are the, how many number of voice channels present. Okay, what do you mean by subsets? It refers to designating setup channels and voice channels, okay, which is done by FCC. FCC means Federal Communications Commission, or it's commission or channel, okay. Federal Communications Commission. Federal Communications Commission. So, which is done by FCC, numbering the channels is done by FCC, okay, and the how many number of voice channels must exist, okay, how many number of setup channels, how to group the voice channels, okay, these are the things done by Federal Communications Commission, okay. So, frequency management means managing the number of or dividing the number of channels into subsets, and assigning these subsets to cell sites, which may be dynamically assigned or assigned fixed in fixed format. Okay. Next, so we have learned about what is meant by frequency management. So what is meant by channel assignment? Channel assignment means assigning the channels. Okay. So means allocation of specific channels to cell sites and mobile unit. See, the cell site must support some n number of channels, and if you are going to make a call, the mobile unit has to be assigned a channel. That's why here is clearly given, channel assignment means allocation of specific channels to cell sites and mobile units. So we are assigning the channels to cell sites and mobile units too. Next, a fixed channel set, that is cell site, which is means here a fixed channel set is assigned to cell site, which is a long term basis, because the cell site used to support n number of channels and used to accommodate the channels to the mobile unit also. Okay, that's why the long term basis with respect to density, we used to assign a fixed channel set to cell site. Next, during a call, the mobile unit on a short term basis, we may assign a channel. For example, there is a handoff. So the other cell site unit has to assign a channel in order to communicate without call dropping. Right? So in that pattern, okay, a mobile unit may assign a channel in a short term basis, okay, which will be taken care by MTSO, mobile telephone switching office. Okay, this is what is meant by channel assignment. Okay, frequency management means dividing the number of channels into subsets and to be assigned, it may be some fixed fashion or dynamical fashion. Channel assignment means we are assigning the n number of channels to cell site on a long term basis. Okay, on a short term basis, we are assigning some channels to or one channel to mobile, that which is particularly done by MTSO. This is what meant by frequency management and channel assignment. This is the first part, okay? So this is the unit 3 first part, frequency management and channel assignment. We'll discuss about these things only. In that, first topic is numbering and grouping. Okay. Numbering and grouping. So what is meant by numbering the channels? What is meant by grouping the channels? Okay. Numbering the channel means, so according to the given data, this is the analysis, okay, previously done. Okay, according to the given data, in 1988, the number of available channels are 832. Remember that we will discuss about AMPS system. Okay, AMPS systems, which is already discussed in unit 1. Okay, so then the number of channels is 832, and that most mobile units operating on 666 channels. 666 channels will be in operating mode. Okay, and the channel consists of two frequency channel bandwidths. One is a low band, one is in high band. These are the points needs to go through. That's it. So there will be two frequencies in channel 1. Okay. So for example, 825.030 MHz for not mobile transmit antenna, not to transmit the mobile unit, or 870.030 MHz at cell site transmit. Okay. The two frequencies in channel 666 are so. So you have taken some example and referring only few frequencies here. Okay, that is 844.98 MHz mobile transmit and 889.98 MHz cell site transmit. Okay, we have a figure, right? Okay, here it is given mobile transmit at mobile transmission. At cell site transmission. Okay, at mobile transmission, here it is given 825 MHz at mobile transmission and 844 means 840, let me 845, 845 at mobile transmission, 825 and 845. Okay, so 825 is here at mobile transmission, okay, and 845 is here at mobile transmission. Right, we are taking two frequencies. Similarly, at mobile transmit 825, at cell site transmit 870. At mobile transmit 845, at cell site transmit it may be some 890 MHz or 891 MHz. Okay, let it be 890 MHz, 870 MHz. So in this figure, see, they have taken one example of mobile transmit and cell site transmit, and they have 825 MHz at mobile transmit and 870 MHz at cell site transmit, or 845 MHz is cell, at the mobile transmit, some 890 MHz, okay, it is here, okay. 890 MHz at the cell site transmit. So what are the frequencies? What is the uplink frequency? What is the low band frequency? What is the up band frequency? High band frequency. They have just taken example. Okay. Don't bother about this. We have taken some channel. In that channel, we have written the respective frequencies here. What is the mobile transmit frequency? What is the cell site transmit frequency? What is the mobile transmit frequency at channel 1? At channel 1, what is the channel 1 means here in the figure? Okay, in the figure you can show. Okay, at channel 1, okay, at channel 1 means here at channel 1, it is 1, channel 1, 825, at the mobile transmit, channel 1, 870 MHz, at cell site transmit, at channel 666, channel 666, at channel 666, 845 MHz, at mobile transmit, at channel 666, 890 MHz, with the cell site transmit, simply by representing the figure, by taking the reference as this figure, they have mentioned these frequencies here. Okay, so at channel 1, at channel 666, okay, same thing you observe in that figure, at channel 1, 825 MHz mobile transmit, at channel 1, 870 MHz cell site transmit, at channel 666, 840 MHz at mobile transmit, and at channel 666, 890 MHz at cell site transmit. Okay, so these things are represented here. And these 666 channels are divided into two groups. Okay, one is block A system, second one is block B system. Okay, so in this figure, we can clearly represent these things. Okay, so there are, and these are the setup channels. So 313, 315, okay, all these things are okay, these are the setup channels here. Okay, other than this, that is from 1 to 312 are the voice channels. Okay, next, here also from 355 to 666. There will be 312 channels there. Okay. And these are the voice channels. This is the frequency chart. We have divided the, see, frequency management chart. We have divided the number of available channels. Into subsets. So what are the subsets here? See, 1A, 2A, 3A, 4A, 5A, 6A, 7A. Okay. 7 subsets are there, okay, which represent A, 1, 2, since we are using a 7 cell reuse pattern, it is given as 7, 1, 1, to 7B. Next 1B to 7B. Next 1C to 7C. Total 7 threes, 21. So how many setup chances are there? 21 setup chances. What are they? 313, 314, 315, 316, 317, and so on up to 333. From 313, 313 to 333. 21 setup chances are there. You can count it. Okay, so 1 to 21. So 21 setup chances are there in block A system. In block B system, 334 to 354. 334 to 354. Another 21. So total 21 plus 21, 42. 42 setup channels are existed. Okay. Anyway, don't bother about what is meant by setup channel. We have a topic called setup channel, what is meant by access channel, what is meant by paging channel. That is the second topic after numbering and grouping. So we'll discuss there clearly what is meant by setup channel. Okay. So other than the 42 setup channels, there exist 312 voice channels in block A and 312 voice channels in block B. In block A, from 1 to 312. In block B, from 355 to 666. Okay. This is the same thing mentioned here. So each block has 333 channels. So each block has from 1 to, in the block A means of 1 to 333 channels. The 42 setup channels are assigned as follows. 42 setup channels are there. In block A, 313 to 333. In block B, 334 to 354. Mentioned here. Okay. So in block A, from 313 to up to 333. Okay. 313 to 333 are the setup channels in block A. And again in block B system, 334 to 354. Another 21 setup channels. 21 plus 21, in block A 21, in block B 21. So total 42 setup channels exist. So remaining are the voice channels. Okay, what are the remaining? 1 to 312 in block A, 355 to 666 in block B. Okay. So here 1 to 312 in block A and 355 to 666 in block B. These are the voice channels other than the setup channels. So new additional spectrum. If you allocate a new additional spectrum, okay, there exist 166 channels are assigned, okay, other than these channels. Okay. So additional channels will be numbered up to 849 MHz. Okay. So we have named up to only some 1 to 666 have been assigned. Okay. Anyway, once I will erase the ink on the slide. Right. Here only from 1 to 666 at mobile transmit. Okay. Additional channels have been assigned. What are they? From 991 to 1023. Okay. From 666 to 716. 716 to 799. Okay. These are the additional channels assigned here. Okay. From 799 to 990, there exists no channels. Okay. That will be used by some other spectrum. Okay. So additional channels will be numbered up to 849 MHz only. So that is from 84 to here only, 849 MHz. Some 894 MHz, that will be circled back. The last channel number is 8023. Additional channels added. Okay. In block A, 991 to 1023 added. In block B, and block A, 666 to 716 and 716 to 799. These are the additional channels added. The last channel number is 1023. There are no channels between 799 to 991. There are no channels existed, okay, which will be used from TV or UHF, some other. Okay. So this is about numbering the channels. Okay. This is about numbering the channels. Okay. We have learned about frequency management, channel assignment, numbering the channels, and today in this class the last topic is grouping the channels. So, how we will group into subsets, okay? I have already mentioned that, okay? In the voice channel, let us go through the slide. Voice channels for each system is 312, okay? We know that voice channel is, for each system is 312. So, go. These are very important, okay? So voice channels are from 1 to 3 to 12. Okay, there are 3 to 12 voice channels. We can group these into any number of subsets, 21 setup channels for each system. Okay, anyway, I have divided the 21 setup channels. Okay, it is logical to group the 3-12 channels into 21 subsets. Okay, so other than the setup channels, that is 313 to 333 in this line, other than the setup channels, for example, in block A or block B. Block B setup channels are 334 to 354. Okay, other than these setup channels, okay, there are 1 to 3 to 12 voice channels. 1 to 3 to 12 voice channels are there. So we have to group these voice channels, 1 to 3 to 12 voice channels, into subsets. Here the subsets are nothing but, see, 1A consists of, okay, see how many numbers are 1A consists of 1, 22, 43, 64, 85, 106, 127, 148, 169, 192, 212, 232, 253, 274, 295. How many numbers are there? How many channels are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So 15 channels are in each subset. There are 15 channels, including the setup channel. There are 16 channels. Okay, including the setup channels, there are 16 channels are there. That 313 is the setup channel. Okay, so other than the 313, there are 15 channels. Including 313, there are 16 channels. Okay, so 1A is a subset, 2A is a subset, 3A is a subset, 4A is a subset, 5A is a subset, 6A is a subset, 7A is a subset. Okay, 1 to 7A. Similarly, 1B to 7B, 1C to 7C, 73 is 21. Okay, 21 subsets are there. So it is logical to group the 312 channels. It is logical to group 312 channels into 21 subsets. And each subset then consists of 16 channels, right? Counted 15 voice, one is set up. Okay, total 16 channels are there. The 16 channels in each subset can be mounted on a frame and connected to a channel combiner. Okay, there is a channel combiner with respect to antenna. So these 16 channels in each subset. So each subset has 16 channels are there, including one setup channel. So 16 channels in each subset can be mounted on a frame and connected to a channel combiner. Okay, with isolation the channel combiner used to provide. So with wide separation between adjacent channels is required for meeting the requirement of minimum isolation is needed. Okay, otherwise there will be interference in the channel combiner. So each 16 channel subset is idealized for each 16 channel. Sorry, each 16 channel subset, 16 channel subset is idealized for each 16 channel combiner. So in a 7-cell pattern, which is a 7-cell pattern, each cell consists of 3 subsets. Okay, 7-cell, each cell consists of 3 subsets. Where I use a picture from IP7. So if you take a cell site, for example, if it is a 7-cell pattern and each cell consists of 3, if it consists of 3 subsets, okay, and the total number of voice channels in a cell is about 45. Total number of voice channels in a cell is about 45. So we can provide 3 subsets. Okay, for example, 1C, 2A, 4B. Okay, providing 3 subsets because each subset consists of 15 voice channels are there, including one set of channel. 15 voice channels are there. So 15 3 is 45. Or if you take 16, including setup channel, 16 channels. 16 3 is 48. Okay, because C mentioned 1C, 2A, 4B. So each cell consists of 1C. Okay, 1C consists of some 16 channels. These channels which consists of, okay, 1C. Okay, from 2A, some 4C. Okay, we can take 3 subsets here. Each cell consists of 16 channels. 16 into 3. Okay. Like that, I have framed there. So we can write like that, no issue. So each cell, so total number of voice channels in a cell is about 45. I have taken 3 subsets. Each subset, 1C, 2A, 4B, as mentioned in the frequency chart, consists of 16 channels, including one setup channel. Okay, other than the setup channel, okay, so 16 into Okay, 16 into 3 that is 48. Okay, remove 3 setup channels. There will be 45 voice channels. There will be 45 voice channels. That is what mentioned here. Okay, there is a easier integer from 1 to 7. Okay, this is grouping of channels. We have grouped from 2A, 1C, 4B in a cell set. Okay, this is what mean by grouping of channels. Okay, so today we have learned about frequency management, channel assignment. And what is meant by numbering of channels? Numbering of channels, grouping of channels, okay, these are the topics we have studied in this class. Thank you.